Sky Sports from the Sporthalle, Hamburg, Germany. It's the B-Wing World Cup of Darts. Time now to meet our players. Representing Team Italy, please welcome Marco Brettagani and Petra Danieli. And representing the Netherlands, it's Raymond van Barneveld and MVG Michael.
Penultimate match of the evening, Michael van Gerwen and Raymond van Barneveld, Team Holland taking on Italy. Been a terrific night of action. Singapore 5-3 winners over the Republic of Ireland. Victories two for Wales, who went 2-0 down against France. Singapore, by the way, winning five legs on the spin, 3-0 down they were. Belgium 5-0 over India. Northern Ireland beating Malaysia. Scotland and England both triumphant. Still to come, Australia and Denmark. We'll focus on this one, the Netherlands-Italy, a prize at stake, a showdown with Spain, which will be very, very tasty in round two. Wayne Mardell and Rod Harrington, your commentators.
Well, thank you, Dave. Yes, looking forward to this game, looking forward to see Raymond van Barneveld, the Premier League champion, pairing up with Michael van Gerwen, the world number one, world champion, and just back from Dubai, where he won that. So these two are on fire. What a baptism for the Italians, Wayne, to come up against these two. And at the moment, I mean, Raymond, as we've said for a long time, we don't know what Raymond's going to turn up. He looks a bit negative at times, but he's got to be on a high after winning that Premier League.
Well, if he's not, then something's wrong. I had the pleasure of playing Raymond in an exhibition match last night, and I won, but of course I was going to win. I'm that good. But he just looks so happy within himself. He's strutting around like a man who knows what he's doing. And he knows he's got the darting world at his feet yet again. Won six world titles between them, five to Raymond and one to this man. I don't think it'll end there. And who's to say they could be lifting the trophy come Sunday night.
And also, with England playing just before them, these guys want to set the stall out. They want to beat the average. They want to hit more 180s. They want to hit more 140s so they can say, we're the favourites here, you know, not the English. And a big task, but both these players, as you said, 95. Incredible players. I mean, we know what Michael van Gerwen can do, loves the game. Raymond, for me, just puts himself down too much. You know, needs to smile a bit more and loosen up. Incredible 60. Dart player when he's on form.
Well, the Italian pairing of Danielle Petri and Marco Brettagani have not really been doing an awful lot within European darts 60. Or even Italian darts for that matter. So this is just way out of their comfort zone. But we shall see. Danielle played in this last year. 60. And they lost 5-3 to Spain and 5-0 to Wales. So not good memories for him.
45.
But this is where it starts for Italy and a lot of the other countries. They see this, they see it on TV. Makes more players want to play it.
58.
So it brings the standard up in those countries. So in years to come, we will have these teams that are capable of pushing, if not to win the title, but certainly to do well. 48. So 16 for double 16 for Barneveld to wrap this first leg up.
Games no on the question. Leg.
Easy as anything.
Second leg is Italy.
Easy indeed. First. No dramas. The second favourites by
82.
The bookies think. Well, Team Netherlands, but in my opinion, I think they should be favourites.
100.
Michael, been playing well for a long time. Barney, back to his brilliant best.
Yes, I agree. If you take the form of the last two or three months, or even since Christmas, then certainly these two, the Dutch pairings, would have been my favourite if I was running the book. But obviously, the English pair, the reigning champions. AD Lewis did look nice, calm. The throw weren't rushed, nice and fluent. Looked really calm, did AD?
Raymond. He changes partners in the World Cup like he changes socks. This is his third partner.
100.
Won it back in 2010 with Ko Stompate. Then, for a couple of years, played with Vincent van der Voort. Now, Michael. Well, I think even if Barney had hit the 51, he wouldn't have gone bullseye, would he?
You wouldn't have thought so, but sometimes the autopilot comes on and you think you're playing up there on your own on a big shot like that. Well, another 16. That leaves double top for Mighty Mike. The fist pump from the young Dutchman puts another leg on the board, 2-0, and in no time whatsoever.
125.
We get to settle down, the Italians.
59.
We did say that it was massively out of their comfort zone, and the thing is, when you are playing to tried and tested players like Barney and Michael, you're not going to get many chances. You've got to create them yourself. You're not going to be given anything. This is better.
140.
Yeah, Daniele Petri can play. Just needs 60. To settle down. And the thing is, Rod, we too rightly know that best of nine, you just don't get time, do you? You've got to hit the ground running, otherwise you're in big
46.
Trouble.
Yes, you're right. And if your opponents are a non-seed and they get out the gate quick, like you say, the short format makes you panic. Look at the Welsh. I mean, we expected the Welsh to be really up for it and what have you, and they did struggle. They only just got over the finishing line. Petri really looking for another 140.
85.
Grabs a treble with the last dart, but not really enough. And this is where Michael has been so brilliant over the last 18 months.
72.
The minute you said that, Rodders, he was always going to miss.
83.
Barney wants double two. Double one now.
Here
we go.
See
a few legs end on double one. 3-0. Easy peasy.
81.
This is just the kind of match you do want, though. You want to play okay or play well like they are and just get it done.
84.
Yes, and also, Wayne, when we talk about who's going to lead the pairing, and you've got a good example here where, you know, a lot of people would have thought perhaps Barney should have been the
81.
Leader. But Michael is the power scorer out of the two. You've always got to have that top scorer going first. He's got the first three darts in every leg. And that's what you've got to do.
97. Barney
just picks the pieces up, sets the shots up.
Yeah, I agree, because I think the aggressor, there's always a more aggressive player in a partnership. I think the aggressor should always throw first.
93.
This is being played at not quite as a sedate pace as some of the others. It just seems to be whenever Michael van Gerwen is involved in a game, it seems to rattle along. Quite a pleasant speed.
100. Oh, that is a perfect treble 20. Be disappointed if he doesn't find 100. Another. Well, as you can see, disappointment. So, Italy now, if he can hit a treble, he can set this up. Give Petri a dart. Oh, he set it up absolutely perfect. can't take that out. So a chance for the Italians to put a leg on the board. And this will be a massive thing for them.
Don't muck around. No missing. Well, I don't know what kind of movement that was. He was playing a violin, I think. Or was he playing them like a banjo?
96.
Settle the Italians down. The last thing you want to do is get whitewashed.
57.
Petri. Oh, look at that. That's absolutely perfect.
100.
Yeah, good darts. I don't know about the haircuts, though, Wayne. I don't know if that'll suit me. The new style.
Try it. That'd be hilarious.
140.
I think Mike would like to try it. They've kind of got matching Barnets.
91.
Well, Barney has just started, not because he's missing, I'm not saying it because he's missing, but he's just started to try 66. To float the dart. And I've said it before, and I'll say it again, it doesn't work for him.
Sometimes when you're not playing at the top of your game, I'd just like to see players step back before they throw that first dart. Like Michael, you can see he's letting go of that first dart before his opponent has actually got past him. And between
102.
When you're throwing and Kirk Bevin, who's our caller, there's not a lot of room between him and you. So I'd just like him to step back a bit. We can see it here, look. Oh, Barney has just waited a little bit. But double top now for 4-1. Double 10. Well, this one should get in because that's a perfect guide. Wow.
20.
Again, a miss from the big fella.
It was after a good setup as well from Michael. Well, he was looking for 260s, double 12. It's not going to be. Got to go down.
28.
Made a mess of it. Can Michael clean this leg up? Make it 4-1. Double five now. Oh, this is just a bit.
No score.
Instead of about cleaning it up, it's just a bit messy. Treble 20.
80.
It's just all turned so scruffy, hasn't it?
Well, we have seen some scruffy legs by the seeds today. Now up to the fives. And that's a bit awkward. Got to come to the right-hand side of that dart.
15.
Oh, the Italians, a massive chance here to break the throw of the Dutch.
I think he's fell to the right man as well.
Gibbs on the fifth leg to Italy. Sixth leg is Italy to throw first.
All the strings on his bow? I don't know. I'm going to keep making something up to I'm eventually right.
Perhaps he thinks they're going to beat him, and we give it the old violin with the excuses.
180.
Cop hold of that. Don't break us, he's saying, because we're going to break straight back. Well, Phil Taylor was on about a possible nine darter.
45.
I wonder. Go on, Barney. First start, straight in that 60. Yeah, less said about that, the better.
125.
But he cleaned the last two darts up very well. And you're right, 81. The first dart. That's a bus ride away from the treble. But another 180 from Mighty Mike will help. The 140 gives Barney two darts and a double. Looking at an 11 dart. I mean, it's ironic how you get a leg, but they can't hit this, they can't hit that, they mess around with the doubles. And then they fire back with, you know, a 12 dart lead. We see that with Northern Ireland this afternoon.
That's why I think that these are the team to beat, because they're obviously not fazed about throwing the last leg away and playing back. That is a joint quickest leg of this tournament. Along with Team Belgium, Hybrex and Hybrex. They had in 11 as well.
44.
Was it the South Africans that actually had a dart at a 10 darter this afternoon? I think it was the South Africans.
87.
And Michael only starting with 44. You see Barney, he's having a go at himself now.
96.
Good last start. Just created a bit of drama for themselves here, and it's kind of unnecessary because they've been in control of every single leg.
58. First round nerves, perhaps a little bit edgy.
100.
The practice room could have gone absolutely brilliant. They're expected to win by everybody. And all of a sudden you get a leg, and then the team get a second leg back. You start to doubt yourself.
Well, in pairs, it really is easy to try too hard, isn't it? You're trying to be perfect every time.
100.
You find yourself just not as fluent as you would be in a singles match. Looking for another treble, needs it.
100.
Well, it's not really
161.
Enough. That leaves 84. He's going back up for the 60. And gets it. What a setup that is.
Well, this would be a great last three darts. Double 12 to clean the match up and go into the second round.
Top side of that. He's darted himself. That was nigh on impossible. It's not in, right? Right, it's not in.
Well, he's going to have a dart at the bullseye to get leg three.
42.
Not that close, but a good effort. I don't think Michael is going to miss the 12s, though.
And the winners of this match, which are Team Netherlands, who beat Italy by 5-2. They will play Spain in the second round. It was a good performance. There was 11 data thrown in there. They can be happy with their night's work. Well, still to come, our last match of the evening. Team Australia, Simon Whitlock and Paul Nicholson.